Hello everyone! 全ての学生にとって大切な夏の1ヶ月半、学習スケジュールは決まっていますか？ディクテーションチャレンジやメールでの毎日の課題管理で学習習慣を身につけ、大幅なステップアップを狙いましょう。夏の過ごし方は、ご所属のスクールまでお早めにご相談ください。Go for it!
Hello everyone! Welcome back to PR2. Today, I have a text talking about the connection between creativity and mental illness. Take a listen. According to an old English saying, genius is next to madness. Indeed, there are many anecdotes about the turbulent inner lives of people famous for their creativity, from mathematicians to artists, which seem to illustrate just such a link. But is there any hard evidence for the idea that there is a correlation between having a fertile mind and mental illness? Recently, scientists have begun to try to clarify this issue, and they have started to produce some undeniable evidence of a connection. They are also beginning to be able to spell out the processes in the brain which explain this connection. The mental disabilities most commonly associated with creativity are mood disorders, such as bipolar disorder, a condition where a descent into desperate depression will commonly be followed by a period of irrational happiness. During the alteration from the first to the second mood, sufferers often become acutely inventive. Word association tests, for example, show that the number of associations they produce far exceeds the number produced by ordinary people. This connection between intellectual ability and mood disorders was verified by a Swedish study, which demonstrated that abnormally intelligent 16-year-olds were over 3 times more likely to develop bipolar disorder as adults. Well, that's all for today, and I'll see you in class. Bye-bye.